We'll look together at Dog and Butterfly by Heart, standard tuning, key of A. I'm going to play through the intro and the verse, and then we'll stop and go back and take a look at it. Okay, so the main grip here, 2nd fret D, 4th fret G, a lot of open E and open A string, but not all the time. Sometimes maybe just the A string, kind of random, watching them play it or listen to the studio. That there's a lot of variation between when that happens and when it doesn't, so I think that's totally, for me, a feel thing, and for you, I'm sure the same way. So you'll hear me putting those in and then sometimes not. So for the intro, I'm going to do that twice. Maybe stay away from it. Slide this up. 2 frets. To 4D and 6G. Moving along. Simple E chord, 1st fret G, 2nd fret A and D, and some close to the bridge, kind of strums, even up would work, maybe with the suspended form with the pinky in on the 2nd fret of the G string, so just some options there. Moving on. The C sharp, I'm barring 4th fret A through high E. I use my pinky to get the 6th fret of the D, G, and B string. I'm not playing either E string, just those inside 4. Then down to an F sharp minor, barring all strings on the 2nd fret, 4th fret A and D. Then to a B chord, barring A through high E on the 2nd fret with my 1st finger. Not playing the low E at all. Dropping, again, my ring finger on the 4th fret of D, G, and B. Using my pinky to get the 5th fret of the B string. And I'm going to kind of walk down on the B string. Taking the pinky out and then the sort of B2 chord. Keeping my bar, but just using the 4th fret of D and G, 2nd fret B. Kind of picking through that with my pick. Put all that together. Takes us to the last lick before the chorus. I'm barring G, B, and high E on the 2nd fret, using my middle finger to get the 3rd fret of B. I'm using my ring finger to hammer on the G string from 2 to 4, and then pull off, and then land on the 4th fret of the D string. Drop my pinky in on the 5th fret of the E string. And then slide that up 2 frets. So my bar is now on the 4th fret of G, B, and E, 5th fret of B string, 6th fret of the D string, and I put on the 7th fret of the high E string. And using the E bass note. the verse. That brings us to the chorus. So for the chorus, I'm using, again, this sort of signature chord. Third time through, I'm going to get 2nd fret D, I'm going to get 4th fret G and 4th fret high E. And then I'm going to walk down through this grip where I'm barring D through high E on 2, 4th fret of the G string with my ring finger, and open A string. And then back to this original grip, 2D and 4G. Switch here after there. And you'll notice I switch from this with my pinky to my ring finger, obviously, so I have a finger, my pinky, to get up there and get that high E string. So it's essentially 1, 2, 3, all that together. G chord, 3rd fret low E, 3rd fret high E, 3rd fret B, don't want the A string. Then a little lick here, basically use my pinky, 3rd fret high E, drop my first finger down to get the 2nd fret high E, then open string. So and then a D grip with sort of the high E string open. You kind of pick that the way you want to hear it. Maybe you use a regular D and then pull your finger out. Here's how I play it. Back to our grip. Slide. F sharp minor. To the C sharp minor. Again, a bar on the 4th fret A through E. 5th fret E. 6th fret D and G. So we've done so again, we're back to this B chord after the C sharp minor, F sharp minor. So I'm going to put my finger in for the suspended, back out, and then back in, and keep that finger there, and move from that grip to this grip. 2nd fret G, and again, barring the 5th fret of the E and B string with my pinky. Something like this. Back to the turn between verses. Okay, so let me kind of play through all that together. Verse, chorus, turn around, and then we'll do the bridge and we'll have it licked. Thank you. here into the second verse, another chorus. And then after that last chorus, let's look at the bridge. We've just finished the second chorus. Open E, second fret E, and then a slide up to the fourth fret into the C sharp minor chord. Back to F sharp minor. Just second fret D and G, back to a D. And I'm pretty much getting all these D chords, D2 chords, open E string. Then back to this G, a C grip. A C grip, third fret A, third fret B and G, or I'm sorry, B and high E. Then I'm gonna make this move again. G chord. And then back to that, open a second fret, and then open E, and then back to our signature chord. So I'm going to try to put all that together slow. The bridge. C grip, this little grip, I'm taking my pinky out on the E string, using my first finger to get the second fret, then down to an E7, to this grip, fourth fret A, second fret G, to this kind of E7 tight grip again, fourth fret G, fifth fret A. So let's put that bridge together again. Covered another chorus. Really, the only other thing that I want to show you here is at the very end where you're just kind of vamping on an A. Nancy will move this grip up two frets, which we've already done. Move it up again to 5 of D and 9 of G. And then you can move that up two more frets. Now we're on 9 and 11, and then two more frets. Now we're on 11 of D and 13 of G. So you basically have some positions there to fool with. And actually live, she'll end it on that chord. So, you know. Great tune that takes me back to some earlier days learning to play the guitar. Thanks for watching.